thank you for coming and good night. I don't know if there's anything we can do to follow that, but we're going to try. We are so glad that you are here tonight for the sounds of Shibboleth. Now, if you don't know what a Shibboleth is, then you probably shouldn't try to pronounce it, or you might get yourself in trouble. It was, if you know, you know, before there was a hashtag IYKYK. Now, this evening's concert is filled with twists and turns, double meanings, puzzles, humor, beauty, even a little bit of spookiness, you might expect. You'll find some program notes that provide a few details. I'm going to try not to bore you by talking too much, but if you want to know more about some of the music and why it's on the program, check those out. Anyone feeling a little cool in the audience? Yeah? Just so you know, the ninth circle of Dante's Inferno is ice. So you're welcome. And if it's too cold out there, you should know it's about 10 degrees warmer up here. And if you want to be in the warm, you can join Choral Union that meets on Monday nights. And then you'll be up here instead of out there. So we thank you for your patience in the cold, and we invite you to sing with us as we get ready for the sounds of sight and Leonardo da Vinci, the notebooks of Leonardo da Vinci in the spring. It's going to be awesome. Now, without further ado, good news, the chariots are coming.
Good news, the good news, the Lord is risen. Good news, the good news, the Lord is risen. Good news, the good news, the Lord is risen.
Choral Union's final piece is a new twist on an old favorite. We commissioned poet Charles Anthony Silvestri to craft some very meta lyrics to a tune you will all recognize. Now, Grieg's original intent was for this music to be satire. It was supposed to be so over the top that the people in the audience would find it absurd and hate it. There's only one problem. The audience didn't get the joke. They loved it, and of course, so do we. But that doesn't mean we can't have a little fun with it anyway. So, without further ado, in der Halle des Bergkönigs. And yes, that was Mozart telling you that. Gives me great pleasure to welcome to the stage, after maybe a little bit of scene readjustment, the Jacksonville University Rivertones under the expert leadership of my esteemed colleague, Dina Barone.
Should I say ghoul evening? Happy Halloween, everyone. Now that the witches have made their brew, we're going to move on to our favorite time of the day, round midnight. After that, we will hear the most romantic, wonderful ballad love song that was actually really written for vampires.
Midnight.
It's been a pleasure performing for you tonight. I hope you've enjoyed our music, and you have a lot of great things coming up in the rest of the program. We're going to end our set with a song that's been around since the 1960s. It's been covered quite a few times, and we hope you enjoy our Spook It.
Bye.
I know it's a concert. You're not allowed to have your phones out until now. Just for now. It's the moment you've all been waiting for. As you were coming in, five of our eagle-eyed student leaders were taking photos of some amazing costumes. And they've chosen their favorites and put them at this QR code. You are now all invited to vote on who that person is. And let me just tell you, you can log in once and you can vote for as many on the list as you wish. You can vote for as many on the list as you wish, and after the University Singers sing Peanut Butter, we'll let you know who you have chosen. The top three will win something awesome. So it matters. By the way, if you are a finalist, we would ask you to prepare to come down to the front between Peanut Butter and Time Warp. And I would suggest use this side of the stage because there's a trip hazard over there. So this is the safer side. All right. So I don't know why the University Singers aren't out here. I told them there are no cues tonight. They just have to come on out. So University Singers, this is not your cue, but you should come in anyway. I wish I could say this was part of the shtick. It's not. Ron, how about you go open the door for them? Thank you, Ron. Ron is our slideshow operator tonight. You have no idea what a stressful job that is. So, thank you, Ron. So about that, there are no cues, right? Come on, you got it. All right, so I think the University Singers have seen something in the sky. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? Oh, no, it's something much more exciting.
And then a heart and say, in a voice so bright, I wouldn't eat you cause you're too tough. sight to see.
It was a one-eyed, one-horned, fire, purple, pickle leader. One-eyed, one-horned,
friendly little people leader.
One-eyed, one-horned, fire, purple, pickle leader. Sure looks strange. What a sight.
I know we sure looks strange to me.
This is so rock and roll. On patrol, no control.
While they're taking a moment to set up, just to tell you, I have never conducted ma show before. This next piece is a new experience for all of us, and it's been so wonderful learning music that is more than 700 years old, or right at 700 years old. You don't get to do that very often. This next piece is actually the inspiration for the concert tonight, everything having double meanings and surprises. Read in your programs about what this originally looked like, and I really encourage you, when you get home, go look at the manuscript and see if you can make any sense of it. Because I have no idea how anyone figured it out. I'm thankful someone much smarter than me did it first, and we can use their score. So here we go, ma show.
Oh.
I'm going to give you a piano lesson. Just take your hand like this, put it on your leg. I want you to tap with your thumb and your pinky as fast as you can. Now you have to do that for the next few minutes with perfect timing and also with artistry. That is what we are welcoming Dr. Scott Watkins to the stage to do. Would you welcome Dr. Watkins? With that experience in your rearview mirror, buckle up for a feverish flight through the countryside as we share the creepiest, most harrowing ghost story ever set to music. Thanks to Goethe and Schubert for the Emkönig.
Thank you.
We are very fortunate that the composer of Rennick's piece, Troll Song, is here with us in person this evening, all the way from Moorhead, Minnesota, where it was 22 degrees when he boarded the plane yesterday. We have had a great time getting to know him and getting to work with him in rehearsal earlier. And before we sing, I just wanted you to know a little bit about the piece. He was telling us that this comes from a story where a young man and a young woman have fallen in love, and the young woman's mother, or the young woman's father, the king, said, no, this can't happen, he needs to die. Well, it just happens that his mother is a witch. Not a good idea. So she shows up in the king's bedchamber that night, and these are her words. Let's just say he ends up suspended in the air against the wall and changes his mind.
Oh.
So where are those finalists? Come on down. Be recognized. Let's see you in person. Come on. Come on. And I'm looking for Summer because she has the magic envelope, I believe. I'm hoping. Well, we'll see. Nice. I think we had more than three finalists. I don't know. Did we? Okay, they're coming. So they're in the nosebleeds, but that's okay. So I should tell you that our top three finishers tonight have won a new car. Oh, wait, no, that's a Steve Harvey moment. Sorry. It says you've won a new jar of peanut butter. I really hope you aren't allergic. If you are, we can probably find you a green scarf or a tie or something, so that'll work. So, where is our... Oh, thank you. Awesome. So, our top three, in no particular order, actually, I'll give them to you. So, third place, Chad from HSM. Who's Chad? To lead us in this most sacred and serious selection of astounding movie madness, Time Warp.
It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll. But listen closely, not for very much longer. I've got to keep control.
Jump to the left.
rhythm of mine. Flip, you're into the time slip, and nothing can ever be the same. You're spaced out on a convention like you're in sensation.